How active are you in pursuit for your next story on a daily basis?
I'm always open to whatever the next story is going to be. Now that I've transitioned from being a producer to a writer-director, now I'm much more picky, and I'm not open to just what'll sell or what I think the marketplace needs. Now I'm looking for just something that really moves me and I feel will be something I want to dive deeply into for a long period of time. As a producer, I could skim along the surface. I never had to dive in that deep, but as a writer or director or both, it's a deep dive, and I have to be willing to commit to that and feel that I can bring something to it, and I'm going to enjoy those characters. I will say that one of the great joys I've learned late in my career as a writer is that moment when you're sitting in front of that black screen and the characters start to speak for themselves and they come alive on your page. And that's, you know, I didn't get to do that as a producer. And so I'm really enjoying that part of it. So I'm always open. I find, you know, stories can come from anywhere. So I'm always open, but now I'm much pickier. You know, when I was running my own little studio at Once Upon a Time Films, when we were making 3 or 4 television movies a year, I had to find lots of material. If we were running a 3-to-1 development to film ratio, I had to have, you know, 9 scripts ready to go for every 3 movies I got made. So that meant if I had to have 9 scripts ready to go, I had to have 20 ideas ready to get scripted, or 30. So it was, we were always looking for stories. I'm much less interested now in that kind of volume. Now I want to find something that has a wow factor.
Does that wow factor come to you right away, or will it kind of fester late at night? You'll like be up and you're like, you know what? Actually, I do like this story. I wasn't sure at first, but then it kind of like festers in your mind a little.
I think they're both. There's certainly the wow factor of, that's the most amazing thing I've ever heard, and I have to have that. I have to have that right now. How do I get that story? How do I get that book or magazine or true life story? When I heard the story of Christine Pelisek being a fact checker at 23 years old and working at LA Weekly and breaking the Grim Sleeper serial killer in Los Angeles, I didn't need to know anymore. But then there's stories that I just can't let go of. I'll go back to and go back to them. But there was the hopefully the next movie I'm going to make. In the Amazon was a story that I chased for 5 years, and it was a true life story, and I just couldn't let it go. And some other producer got it and failed at developing it, and I would call every 6 months, and after about a year and a half they abandoned the other producer and went with me, and I just could not let it go. It was a story I had to tell. One way or the other, I was going to tell that story.
Sorry, Stan, is that your next project that you're referring to?
I believe my next film will be The Girl Who Fell from the Sky, and that's the true story of Julianne Kepke, who in 1972 was living in Peru, going to the American school. She was 18, was in her senior year. Her parents were noted zoologists. She had lived part of her childhood in the Amazon. Her parents were cataloging butterflies and bats. And then when she got to middle school, they moved her to Lima, and she grew up there, spoke perfect German, perfect English, perfect Spanish. And because it was, they're on a different schedule than us because their seasons are different than us, their school year ends in December. So she was both graduating and going to her prom in December, and her dad wanted them to go to the Amazon on Christmas Eve, and she wanted to stay. And so he went early, and she and her mom stayed behind in Lima, and she went to her prom, graduated with her friends, and then they got on a plane. And when the plane was over the Amazon, it was hit by lightning twice and disintegrated in midair, and she was in the window seat, still strapped in. And as she said, I didn't leave the plane left me. And she found herself at 15,000 feet in her chair, upside down, pinwheeling. And she fell, blacked out, fell, hit the canopy of the Amazon, which broke her fall. It's a miracle. Absolutely, she's the longest free fall without a parachute. And the canopy broke her fall. And she landed in the Amazon, woke up, had nothing but a broken collarbone that she knew of. She had one shoe, lost her glasses, and for the next 9 days followed the river and the lessons that she learned from her father and her own desire not to die, and was rescued. And she's a friend of mine now. She's now in her 50s, and she's an extraordinary woman. She spends half her year in Munich and the other half in the Amazon trying to save the rainforest. And we're gonna go down to Bogota and the Amazon and hopefully tell that story at the beginning of next year.